Hello everybody from Plant Reviews. Today is the 18th of April and I'm talking now about Narcissus iohannis. This is a pretty small species, Narcissus from Spain. It is tall, about I would say 15 centimeters tall. The flowers are pretty small. It is about, the flower I would say it is in length probably 3 centimeters and a half, and in width probably probably about 1 centimeter, because the perianth, the tepals, are very strongly reflexed. As you can see, if they were kept flatter as in other daffodils, probably the diameter would be about 4 centimeters across. This daffodil, as I said, comes from Spain and is in the section Ganymedes, together with another famous species daffodil, is Narcissus triandrus. Some triandrus have a beautiful, including some varieties of triandrus, has a beautiful fragrance. This one, unfortunately, I can't smell any fragrance at all, so I'm a bit disappointed, because I was really hoping that this daffodil would have been fragrant. Anyway, it is a beautiful flower, very strongly reflected. The color is kind of primrose yellow, as you can see, fading to white when the flower ages. You can see the flower at the bottom is a little bit more greenish yellow than the one at the top, because the flower at the bottom is more opened more recently than the one at the top. I have been cultivating it in this small greenhouse with other tiny bulbs of daffodils and tulips, and it's done pretty well. However, this daffodil is supposed to be hardy in the United Kingdom, so I live in USDA 8 and I bought this daffodil from Rare Plants. So it can actually be grown in the garden. I didn't plant it in the garden because, as I said, it's pretty small and I have quite a lot of weeds in my garden growing, so I prefer to keep it to keep only big daffodils, big and tall daffodils in my garden that actually show off pretty well, as you can see, like these two beautiful poeticus that are in bloom at the moment. This is a daffodil that anyway is has a beautiful shape. You can see it's very delicate. The tepals are about the same size, the same length of the corona, and if you like miniature daffodil, this is definitely a very elegant daffodil. Unfortunately, the only thing that is a little bit disappointing for me is that it's not fragrant at all. As usual for daffodils, this need to be planted in autumn and in well-drained soil, and ideally full sun or at least a partial shade. The soil needs to be very well drained and needs to be kept fertilized and watered during the growing season, so between autumn and spring. The plants will lie down in late spring or early summer and the bulbs go dormant. As usual, I hope that you enjoy the video. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, it would be great if you can please give a thumbs up, and if you like this video and other videos on my channel, would be great if you can please subscribe. It is completely free for you, but in this way you help me to get acknowledged by YouTube that you like my videos, and YouTube in turn can promote my channel and support me to do even more videos. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye.